What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, I'm sure by this time you've all heard about the tragedy that took place at the Christian school in Nashville. I've told you before that I'm very concerned about the youth in this country, and it seems like opposing forces are also concerned about the youth for similar reasons. See, good and evil both recognize that in order to influence the future, we got to influence the young. We got to influence the culture. I was watching a video by another popular YouTuber named Tim Pool, and he emphasized the fact that it is imperative that we influence culture, that we change social structures, because the other side that doesn't mean good for this society is doing pretty well at negatively influencing the youth. Just look at social media, Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, Snapchat, all negative influences on the young. And we're losing the battle on that front. But it's imperative not only for us to win the social battle, but to also win the physical battle that's obviously taking place in this country. I came across a story in the USA Today I wanted to share with you. Let's read. Why do mass shooters target K-12 schools? Here's what we know after Nashville shooting. Well, we could end the story right there with the headline. Because we know the obvious, right? When these deranged shooters, deranged killers choose their targets, it's not random. These things are selected. And they go to places where they feel like they can go out in a blaze of glory. And they never look at that blaze of glory as 5.56 rounds or 7.62 rounds or 6.5 Creedmoor rounds ripping their face off. They always search for places where they can unleash their fury with no lead coming back at them. So to answer the question, we know exactly why they choose these types of targets. The aftermath of a mass shooting at a private Christian school in Nashville, Tennessee, that left 3 9-year-olds and 3 school workers dead Monday, has renewed debate about why shooters target schools. There's no simple answer. Oh, yes, there is. There is. But because schools may have limited security and the deaths of young people draw significant attention, they can be attractive targets for assailants, experts told USA Today. Why do shootings happen at schools? Robin M. Kowalski, a psychology professor at Clemson University in South Carolina, recently studied shootings at K-12 schools and colleges and other mass killings. She and her colleagues found that the majority of people who attack K-12 schools are white, male, have a median age of 15, feel marginalized or bullied, and use the events to take their own lives. And they tend to come from inside the school community, she said. K-12 school attacks are night and day from college shootings, which are more likely to occur after interpersonal conflicts, Kowalski said. People who attack K-12 schools are more likely to have a history of psychological problems, long-term or acute rejection experiences like a recent breakup or a fascination with death, guns, and violence, including a fascination with school shootings, she said. The individuals behind the Sandy Hook and Columbine shootings, among others, had been diagnosed with an assortment of psychological conditions, Kowalski wrote for the Brookings Institution. Because most school shootings are lone wolf attacks, an act committed by one person, one would have to understand the mindset of the assailant, including their history, grievances, and mental health status, to truly understand their motive, said Javed Ali, a former top official at the FBI and Department of Homeland Security and an associate professor of practice at the Gerald R. Ford School of Public Policy at the University of Michigan. Every shooter seems to be driven by different factors, he said. He has a point. Although we can analyze data and come up with different generalizations and say, okay, well, they're generally white male, they're generally around a certain age, they generally come from a certain background or have certain psychological diagnoses in their background. Every shooter's different. So we have to look at them individually. For example, they say most of the school shooters in K-12 are white male. That was not the case in Nashville. This was a white female. And they say, well, okay, most of the shooters in the K-12 schools are age 15. This female shooter in Nashville was 28 years old. Have you ever met a person who was in their late 20s, who hadn't had their life together yet, who seemed to be scrambled in the mind, unfocused, going every which way mentally, and that mental problem having an outward expression that you could see? It seems, based on the evidence that is showing in this example, this woman, adult human female, was clearly going through some type of identity crisis that may have been an outward manifestation of something much deeper going on in the mind. And why does she choose to direct her rage at a K-12 school when she doesn't fit the description of a typical K-12 shooter? I read you the stats. And why would she choose a Christian school specifically? Now, she attended the very school that she shot up. There may have been something triggering there, but they looked at the record, said she was an excellent student at the school. Is it possible that something sinister, something demonic, something nefarious had entered her mind and altered her thinking and made her anti-Christian, made her thinking process antithetical to everything she was taught as a child, made her so resentful of God, the Bible, and believers that she took out her rage in that direction when she didn't fit the description of a typical K-12 school shooter? Or am I putting too much on it? Is it much simpler than that? Is it just the fact that she knew there were no guns there? Well, in that case, why do school shooters shoot up schools? For the same reason they shoot up churches. They believe there's no guns there. There's no blowback. What do you think about this story? What would motivate a person to go to a Christian school and take out such rage on innocent 9-year-old babies? Not to just take your life because you're depressed and disappointed, but to take the lives of children. Am I off base here? Because if this ain't evil, if this ain't devilment, then I don't know what is. Let me know in the comments. I'd like to know what you think about this shooter choosing a Christian school and little Christian babies to take out her rage. Why do shooters choose schools? Let me know. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share the video so we can get more musicians involved in the conversation, y'all. Like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.